Imagine yourself having a steady income stream from publishing a book without requiring a lot of writing, doesn't require shipping out orders, or even sourcing inventory. This is exactly what I'm going to show you in today's video, how to do KDP research, a step-by-step guide for selling no-content and low-content books. Hey guys, my name is Christina Ramos. I create self-help journals to sell on Amazon KDP. Welcome to my channel. Please consider subscribing and hit the bell icon for future video updates, and let's begin. The best part about selling low-content book is that it doesn't actually require you to write a book, and you can do this at home and anywhere in the world, and it's going to be done within a few minutes. Once you have enough books for sale and you are taking this seriously, you can start to create a nice passive income stream. So if you're just as pumped as I am for this video, let's get right into it. Let's start with step one, we call retrieve journal writing experience. Let's recall how you process your thoughts, say in your career, relationships, and personal life. Do you jot down your thoughts and reflections from things that happened around you in a journal notebook, a diary, or reflection notebook? Do you write things like your life goals, objectives, expectations, observations, events, adventures, and many more? Look back on the diaries and journal notebooks you have. Is it a blank journal that only has lines for writing? Or is it a journal with quotes on each page, days of the week, and months listed? These questions will bring us up to step two. Step two is understand KDP no-content and low-content books. What is KDP? KDP allows you to self-publish ebooks, paperbacks, and hardcover books for free. A no-content book usually refers to a book that has no written content in it. The interior is blank or nearly blank. An example of this would be a blank journal that only has lines for writing. And for low-content book is one that has some written content, but far less than one would find in a typical fiction or non-fiction book, which is hundreds of pages of contents. But how the heck would I even start the ball rolling? And that's a great question, because today I'm going to introduce you to BookBolt. The best tool for low-content book creation. It's a tool that allows you to create and scale a book publishing business without writing a single word. From picking a niche, finding keywords, creating an interior and cover, BookBolt helps in all aspects of your low-content publishing business. It has hundreds of different types of templates for the interior, and the cover creator is extremely easy and user-friendly. You can look up the profitable keywords so that it can rank on the first page in Amazon and it can make more sales. Step 3 is research. You have to do product research on what customers are buying for or what they want to buy. Without researching what customers actually want to buy, you will obviously waste your time and never see a sale come through because you are targeting the wrong buyer. So research tip number one is, the very first thing you do before you conceive a book is to find out exactly what people are buying. Do this by looking at two things. Sales rank, if a product has a sales rank at all on Amazon, it has sold before, and reviews. If there is a review and it has a verified purchase red tag next to it, someone has actually found and purchased the book before. Now let's sign into BookBolt. The first thing you want to do is come up with a keyword or phrase to look at. Let's say you want to create a book. Here we can see that the books are selling with that specific keyword, and you can tell right away that it is about our niche, mindfulness coloring book for adults, that it is priced competitively at $5.99, it has reviews, and it has good sales rank with the amount of estimated sales showing. So there is demand in this niche. Now if you click on the book title, this will open up the product in Amazon. You want to head down to the reviews and actually look at them. See how they have the red verified purchase tag. That means people bought them and liked the product. So perfect, there is a good demand for this niche.
We can further confirm this by looking at the right side of the BookBolt product search. These related keywords will show you what other people are likely typing in, as well as how many searches per month they get in Amazon. Our target keyword here gets over 1,602 searches a month. So this is exactly what you are looking for. Now you know the niche has demand, and you can go create your own unique products to sell to that audience. Research tip number two is the book cover. Is it readable? Book cover design is a mixture of images, text, and information. So to sell your book effectively, you need to understand how each of these aspects interact with the others. Therefore, look for inspiration and ideas for your cover. The most important feature of book covers is to have the ability to connect with the target market. So your first stop for inspiration should always be the other books in your category. Let's head on to Amazon and key in the keyword, for example, mindfulness coloring book for adults. Notice how the best seller there has massive text and you can't miss it and know exactly what it says.
Research tip number 3, to look for in the front page. With so many people putting up line journals and notebooks, the act of simply making a custom front page on the inside of your book can set your book unique from everyone else.
The thing is, when a customer actually lands on your product, chances are they are going to click that look inside feature to see what it is they will actually be buying. To convert that customer to sale, you may add a front page that's interesting. Take this for example, one we were looking at earlier as cover inspiration.
When I click to look inside, look at what this book is doing. They are building a brand and email list with their low content book. Research tip number 4, research for the price. Can you compete? Look at the average price of the top selling products for your target keyword and then ask yourself, can I make a good margin at this price and is it worth it? Let's head over to the product search module and select the correct category from the drop down menu. If you do not see your category, just select general. Then you have to enter your keyword and click on search.
So in this example, you can see that we looked in the journal category for self-care books. You can scroll through the results to see which some of the top sellers are pricing. But results data is one of the most helpful pieces of information inside of BookBall. This will give you an idea of what the average price is as well as the lowest and highest price. Keep in mind that these are ranked by best sellers, so anything within this range would work out perfectly.
With all the data presented, we need to use our brain. The brain has a part called cerebrum where high intellectual functions take place. The brain is exposed to stimuli at which point it analyzes and evaluates information. So this is how I analyze and evaluate the result data for my pricing.
In this result data, the average price is 9.85. So I'm going to lower it down to 7.99, a difference of 1.86 from the average price during launch. And once my book is constantly on sale, I'm going to adjust my pricing to 8.99. This is actually what I've done with my book that's selling well.
Why end my price 89? This psychological pricing is driven by the fact that we read from left to right. So when we encounter a new price at 7.99, we see the 7 first and perceive the price to be closer to 7 than it is to 8. So ending your price in a 9 persuades customers that you're offering a great deal.
Another method is to explore the cloud. Let's explore the cloud module to pick up the best price for your book. Once you locate a book, you will see a little clock icon. Clicking the icon will bring up the sales rank history and pricing chart. From here, you can determine if the buyers in this niche are price sensitive or not. You can see how this seller has reduced its price and you can also notice its sales rank. Using this information, you will have a clue on how to price your book.
Research tip number 5 is to read reviews for similar books. If there is a book in your niche or several books that have reviews, go read them. They can sometimes provide valuable insight on what you could change with your book. As you research products like yours, make sure to read reviews. Reviews give you information about what customers like and don't like about a product. Checking for reviews tells you a few things. the niche sales, and people either dislike the product or like it enough to tell the world about it. I hope you guys find this video useful. Again, be sure to get started with Book Vault today. Link is in the description. Get 20% off on any subscription. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in my next videos. Bye.